as thousands watched in horror.
And let's move away from the scene.
A vintage airplane competing in a Nevada air race crashed into spectators.
And the next thing I saw was a wall of debris going up in the air, and that's what I got splashed with. When it was over, the wall of debris noticed there was pieces of flesh.
Numerous spectators were killed, as well as the pilot, 74-year-old Jimmy Leeward, a Hollywood stuntman who's been flying since he was a teenager. In a pre-race interview shot earlier in the week, with his World War II-era fighter plane behind him, Leeward was optimistic he'd do well in the race.
We're as fast as anybody in the field, and or maybe even a little faster. But to start with, we really didn't want to show our hand until about Saturday or Sunday.
But Saturday became a day of mourning for his fellow pilots and crews who were packing up and heading home after the event was canceled.
The poor people that got hit by the shrapnel, I have so much empathy for them because now they have to live with this the rest of their life.
Authorities said it appears a mechanical failure was to blame.
It's not just about that piece of metal, but it's any other piece that we can find where we can make a recommendation, including oversight and anything else.
This accident may not only lead to the cancellation of this annual event, it may also jeopardize the future of the entire extreme sport of air racing.
I'd hate to see this not continue. However, I think it's pretty unlikely that we're going to see this happening here.
Prior to this accident, 17 people have died at the National Championship Air Races since their start in 1964. But this was the first time people on the ground were killed. Haven Daly, Associated Press, Reno, Nevada.